Alex, good? Ready to go?
Yeah, let's do it.
Hey, Alex, can you describe the journey that you've been on from, you know, undrafted and working your way through the G League, a two-way contract, mm-hmm. playing well in the limited time that you get, and then finally now getting the full roster spots and having a chance to play minutes? How has that whole process been, and how does it build into this year for you?
Yeah, it's been an interesting but fun journey, you know, starting out in OKC, training camp with them, and then was with the Blue for the whole year, 50 games, playoffs, and then Summer League with the young guys, Zoe, Jay Hart, Kuz, and then from there, the two-way. I think everything for me has just been about opportunity and about being myself. You know, I think that's what's been so great about this journey from the two-way, and then the, like you said, limited games, like 60-something games, and then now being on the roster. I've just been myself the whole time. Done exactly the same thing that I've been doing since I was a fifth, sixth grade kid, just playing hard and just playing the game the right way and loving it. You know, basketball for me is such a joy. I have so much fun playing and competing with my teammates, and I think it's been a lot of fun. As long and as strenuous as the journey has been, it got me to where I was aiming, and I think it's just the beginning.
Alex, over here.
There have been maybe 200 two-ways, roughly. I don't know the exact number that have come in since the inception of it. Maybe five have been able to move on to like multi-year guaranteed contracts. Can you kind of share your experience and how did it work for you? Why did it work for you? Was it luck? Also, before you answer, when was the decision made on the mustache? Did that happen recently?
Yeah, that was over the summer. Recent girlfriend said that she wasn't a fan, so you know, you pick your battles on that. Yeah. Any man can attest to that in here. The two-way for me was honestly, anybody that's asked me about it, I've told them that it's been the best case scenario. You know, it was exactly what I needed coming after that first year in OKC with the Blue on the G League side. It was an opportunity for me to do exactly what they laid it out for, to get experience with the NBA game, NBA team, but also have the G League to help me continue on the path of developing. And I think that's what I did. The G League side here with South Bay, thank you to them. I know they'll see this and hear this, but they helped me so much just get through the quick turnarounds, the long G League trips to late night texts, to jump on a plane and go to a different city. They helped me get through that, and the coaching staff and the guys that we've had around on the teams have been such good people that it really eased the transition for me. But like I said, just being able to keep developing my game and kind of figuring out where I could attack, where I needed to be more aggressive, where I needed to run the team in different scenarios, and then ultimately having the opportunity to do it with the big team in an NBA game, everything that those 2 years is just kind of built up to this point. You know, anybody who watched the end of last year versus the end of the first year could tell I was more comfortable. I was just moving at a quicker pace. Like, I understood the game better, and it was just experience. It was just me having more time and being able to understand how I could take advantage of different things in the game.
Hey, Alex, back here. What's something you worked on this summer to add to your game to prepare to play a bigger role with, you know, the likes of LeBron and AD?
You know, the crazy thing about that is I don't think there was anything, there was nothing concrete in the game that I think I really needed to add. I think it was just about developing and, like we said, just continuing to improve on the things that I was already doing well. Make good decisions as a point guard, being able to decipher whether it's to run the team or be aggressive in transition and push the pace, continue to shoot the ball really well. You know, that was one thing at the end of the year. I didn't realize it till during the summer when people kind of pointed it out, the statistical 3-point percentage or whatever it was, plus minus stuff, like that was all really good, but it was really just me and the rhythm of the game, me just being comfortable. So I think for me, it was just about continuing to stay consistent with the things that I did at the end of last year, because I think if I can do those things for 82 games plus, I think I'll be in a good position to help this team win.
Alex, to your right,
over the summer and the last couple months of the season, you've really developed into fan favorite, mm-hmm. cult hero type player. I think I've seen some articles with you acknowledging that.
Yeah.
What's it been like for you, just having that type of appreciation?
Yeah, it's always great. I appreciate Lakers fans so much for riding with me for the last 2 years and then hopefully into the future. But I don't know why they chose me. You know, I wish I had an easy answer. The thing I like to tell people is that Lakers fans are like seldom few sports fan bases that actually understand the game that they're rooting for. You know, they're knowledgeable about the game of basketball. So I think they appreciate the intensity that I play with and how I play the game. And I think from there, they just kind of chose me as the token meme guy and video guy. And I'm not really sure why. Maybe we can get a poll out there, a consensus to figure out why they chose me. But I enjoy it. You know, there's no such thing as bad publicity, and it's always good. It's always better to have them rooting for you than against you.
Building on that topic of you as sort of a cult figure among Lakers fans, what does that sort of tell you about the Lakers as a brand to be able to put pretty much anyone who's on the roster on that sort of platform mm-hmm. for the public?
Yeah, I mean, the Lakers are one of the few sports franchises that is recognizable worldwide. You know, no matter where you go, people know about Kobe, they know about Kareem, they know about Magic, they know about Shaq. Like, you can go anywhere in the world and people know about the Lakers. And I think that's just it's just a special opportunity for me to be able to get to enjoy this for however long I am. Thankfully, I got to stay here for at least another 2 years, which is what I wanted to do. I enjoy it so much. But yeah, the Lakers as a franchise and as a fan base is just a special place. Like, it's really hard to explain it to people that don't understand, but the magnitude of it is worldwide.
Alex, I know Frank was telling us that nothing has been set in stone as far as starting lineups and rotations and, mm-hmm. and that thing. Has anyone come to you and explained to you that this is wide open, or how do you kind of see sort of your chance at gaining a bigger role in this team than last year? Is it mm-hmm. do you feel like it's a pretty open shot for you?
Yeah, I mean, I would say so. I think the mindset of this team is we want to win, you know. And I think I don't think there's anybody on the team that is going to have hurt feelings or poor intentions if we're winning games and certain people are playing certain minutes. For me, it's never been about starting, coming off the bench, scoring points. My whole basketball career has just been revolved around playing hard and winning, being a good teammate. So, I mean, for me, it's pretty easy. You know, whatever I have to do to help us win is what I'm going to do. Or if that's me on the bench cheering on my teammates, making sure that everybody's ready to go, whether it's me starting, whether me coming off the bench, you know, it doesn't matter for me. You know, I know a lot of people might say that, and people may not even believe that, but I mean, that's the truth. At the end of the day, I just want to win.